beep, beep, beep. I'm out the way.
Let's go. Kendrick Lamar finally responded. Like, share, subscribe, and let's get into it. So if some of you haven't seen Kendrick Lamar recently, and I mean an hour ago, maybe by the time this video comes out, 2 or 3 hours ago, he just released Euphoria, a new diss track aimed at Drake, and it's interesting. I'll be honest, I had to listen to this diss track a few times, which isn't abnormal for Kendrick's music. When he creates songs, he has so many layers to everything, you really have to comb through it to break it down. This is why this beef is so interesting, because both of these guys really know how to layer things and intricately and strategically get their point across. Drake is crazy when it comes to subliminals, when it comes to psychological warfare, which, by the way, is what I think brought Kendrick out. But Kendrick himself is good at doing these things as well too, especially on a world stage. By the way, I reversed the first 2 seconds of Kendrick's song where it's played backwards, and what he says is
"Everything they say about me is true,"
which is hilarious because you can tell there's a bit of sarcasm there. And even so, I think he's trying to 8 Mile himself as well, where it's like, yeah, I am short, yeah, I do have small feet, but let's talk about you. Clarence had really nice parents. He may have waited quite a bit, but as far as our investment goes, he gave us a tremendous return. I'll be honest though, the first minute of this song to me is kind of trash. I'm just keeping it real. I'm not trying to be like biased. I love KDOT. I love Drake, but I also love KDOT too. But it was just a waste of time. It's a very like R&B feel. And to me, I don't know about you guys as fans, but with this whole Drake and Kendrick thing, I want to see blood, not in the J. Cole way. I know nobody's going to die. Nobody's going to fight. But I want people to come out swinging. And when I heard that like R&B type vibes, I was like, what is this? Earth, Wind and Fire, bro? I don't need to hear this. I'm not here for the Isley Brothers. Okay? This is boring. Get to the real nitty gritty of everything. This isn't the time for the strawberries and champagne R&B vibes. And I think, you know, it's probably a deeper thing than that. I think he was trying to kind of maybe poke fun at Drake and how he does R&B and how he doesn't give people the rap that they're always waiting for. For instance, on For All the Dogs, he promoted that as a hardcore hip-hop album and then gave us all an R&B album. So as far as that goes, I think Kendrick definitely stuck the landing on that, trying to mess with our heads and in turn make fun of Drake at the same time. It's very clever, very cool, but at the same time, I think 10 years from now people won't really remember that reference and they're not really gonna care, and so they're gonna talk shit about that first minute. That being said, everything else slaps. He definitely builds up everything over time. In classic Kendrick Lamar fashion, he has a lot of awkward flows, but they're aggressive. They kind of hit hard. It takes you a second to get into it, I'm not gonna lie, but I did like the start of the second part of his song. But I think where it really, really gets to be the best is when it gets about halfway through to the diss track. That's when he really starts talking all this mess. He brings up that Drake, again, is from Canada, and he's not even really part of this American culture that's created hip-hop, which is something that I knew was going to be a factor, but the fact that he's like really bringing that up and throwing it out there, I do think is interesting. And I've been learning this too, because my family's Jamaican, and I was just talking on a live stream about hip-hop and stuff, and I was saying about how Caribbean people's involvement and in the birth of it and this, that, and the third. And I cannot tell you how angry those people were on the live stream. These are all FBA people. If you don't know what FBA means, it's Foundational Black American. They were talking about how we basically had no hand in it whatsoever, and we should be thankful that they ever bestowed this beautiful music upon us and all sorts of shit, which, you know, whatever. I don't want to get into that, but I'm just saying that because obviously Kendrick is kind of taking that angle as well. And I'm kind of wondering if maybe that's how a lot of mainstream America feels. And if that is how mainstream America feels, Drake is in for a long day. He was already in for a long day because as far as like real hip hop goes, they want Kendrick to win. They do not want Drake to win. Even mainstream wants Kendrick to win. They don't want Drake to win. You know, Drake is one of those people who everybody loves his music, but they hate him. Like, it's almost like cool to hate Drake. Like, I've been around people before when it comes to music and stuff like that, where it's like they know nothing about hip hop, but they say they hate Drake as if they will give them like cool points, you know? And it's like, bro, you don't even listen to rap at all. And it's like, you're talking shit about him. Like, if you know, you know, he can rap, you know? But these are just things that I think goes into the politics of this entire beef. A lot of these disses are a bit superficial, you know, saying that, you know, he's light-skinned, he doesn't feel black enough, he's Canadian, he acts hard, but he's soft, I'm only here for the melodies. These are all fair critiques as well, too. I mean, these are things that people have thought about Drake for quite a bit of time, so I'm sure he's just getting it off his chest. Plus, we're bringing up Push-Ups, Drake's first diss track against Kendrick Lamar. A lot of those disses were superficial, too. You know, I think a lot of people wanted Kendrick to come out swinging like crazy, crazy hard. He's definitely putting this out to test the waters. He's trying to see where this is going, and I'm excited for it. I think Drake is in the same zone, too. I mean, these last two diss records that he's dropped have mostly made fun of Kendrick's height and his small shoe size and all that, you know? Taylor May Freestyle was a little bit more cutting, but it was in its own way, you know what I mean? I think it more was cerebral and messed with Kendrick's head a lot, which definitely gives Drake some extra points. Because you can feel how angry Kendrick is in this diss track, and I think a lot of it stems from Taylor May Freestyle. You know, everybody wants to talk crap about, oh, you can't use Pac's voice. But at the end of the day, it was a very, very clever way of using AI. And to me, it's pretty much my favorite Drake diss track ever. Because I can only imagine how I would feel if I was Kendrick, you know, being somebody who's supposed to be representing the West Coast. And then somebody I'm beefing with personifies the people that blessed me with that achievement. I think that was a very, very solid argument. And honestly, I'm sure when he first listened to that track, Kendrick was in his living room in the dark, sipping on Hennessy, mad as hell, ready to write some bars. And you can tell, too, because in this song, Kendrick is going in on Drake for everything. He's cracking on him like we're in the lunchroom. He's letting out his inner DMX on The Breakfast Club.
I don't like anything about Drake. Mm-hmm. Mom, I don't like his voice. I don't like what he talks about. I don't like his face. People. I don't like the way he walks, nothing.
I'm not gonna lie, the song starts off slow, but it definitely ramps up. And he has some good punches in there, man. Like that whole 20v1 line where he flipped it, where he goes, 20v1, it's me versus 20 of your writers. That was nice. He's definitely not pulling any punches, but he's letting Drake know, bruh, we can really get into it if you want to get into it. I'm so happy that we're finally getting to see this beef come together, and I'm proud of Kendrick too, because to be honest, a lot of his stans were pretending as if he doesn't have to address anything and the like that verse is enough and blah blah blah. No it's not. Especially when you're trying to act like Drake is soft and then he comes back to you with two diss tracks and you have nothing. That's unacceptable. And he showed that he knew it was unacceptable, so he stepped up to the plate. Dude is killing it. I can't wait to see where this beef goes, man. We're going to get some good music out of this. But what do you guys think? Do you think Kendrick's going to win this beef? Do you think Drake's going to win this beef? Do you think Kendrick's new diss really stacks up against Drake's two disses? Because I think this song is better than Push-Ups, but it's not better than Taylor Made. So let me know what you think in the comments. We'll talk about it later. I'll see you. Peace.